Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. Today we're going to do a combination microcannula and needle lip filler technique. Let's go watch it being done. So we made the opening for the cannula port, and we're here, we're using a 25 gauge. Important not to touch the steel, but I am priming it, and you might see there that the drop of product is a little bit proximal to the opening. So it's not right at the tip, and we have to factor that in when we inject it. So we already pre-cleansed and she had another procedure done. So she's a little red and glossy from the product we put on. Now, we go in through that port and the bottom lip has two tubercles. So I'm not injecting yet. I do all retrograde with a microcannula. So I'm going through the tissue. Now, I can see that I'm not getting support there to push it, so I'm gonna use this finger, it's a two-handed technique, to add a little bit of support so I can go through. And I see where I'm at, and because of that port opening being where it is, now a little resistance here, I am gonna put a little bit of product in, just to enough to create a potential space. Now, I'm pushing through to that tubercle, and adding a little bit of product to create a potential space, and then I can advance. I know I have to overshoot there just a little bit. By overshooting means that my opening is where I want it to be, yet the tip is a little more distal than I want it to be, and you can see it right there. Now, I want to create, she wants product right to the edge, and so that's what we're going to do. We're going to create product all along that lip, and we're coming right to the edge. Here we're creating an overall fuller lip from center right to the edge. Now a lot of people might say, well, we should taper it there. The look now for many people is running volume throughout the whole lip. And while not purist, people now have the opportunity to decide what they want and the style they want. And of course, hyaluronic acids can be dissolved and they go away and change over time. So people's style can change. So we filled this side and now I'm putting traction with my left hand, right hand, creating an opening. I overall do four openings, one, two, and then two on the other side. You could make one opening on this side and go up and down as well. You could make an opening right here, but I like the two per side technique. And so there's no blood at all involved with this technique. I can just see my opening. Can just find your opening here. Traction with your non-dominant hand. We've cleansed the skin, so we're gonna come in and we have to counter angle, and also we can move and straighten out our plane to get where we wanna be into the lip, and that's where we're at now. So, injecting, and without talking, it's a fairly quick procedure. We're walking through it, so we're taking a little extra time. But now I want to go a little further, so I want traction and pushing to where I want to be. I like a one-handed technique. Some people like to hold this like a dart. I don't like that. I like to be ready to inject at all times and be putting micro doses in and watching my fill. And then traction here if I need it to go further. I think two hands and holding it like a dart doesn't really offer you anything more than one. But what it does do is you gotta change position, and it really is a two-handed technique. So I'm taking volume right to the edge. You can see I'm at the edge here because we want an overall full look. So I'm gonna stop right there. So here we're entering, the upper lip has a little more fibrous tissue. Perfect. And you can feel it kind of go through, and you can hear it. So for the patient, it can be a little odd. Doing okay?
Mm-hmm.
Great. Looks great. And here we're filling. We wanted to fill this lip all along. We wanted to discuss the aesthetic look, and we wanted a full upper lip right to the edges. We don't want to taper. So I'm looking to see where is it filling easily and where we need more. And I can see here I need a little more. So I'm adjusting the cannula, moving it back and forth to create volume in that one little area. where I'm not getting the fill that I want, and then I see it fill. So I lay off the trigger. Here we go. And just filling, and now I'm gonna come right to the corner where we want. We want it some right here. Okay,
perfect.
So we're coming up on this quadrant. Again, a little fibrous tissue here, so sometimes there's a little pop, but you don't wanna put product right there. And you're around the area of the superior labial artery too, keep in mind. And we do want lateral volume again on this patient here. So I add a little bit, create a potential space, and push through it. And you can see this is a 25 gauge cannula. It's very smooth. I think the 27s act more like needles, and I think overall, most people would agree 25s are safer and more of the standard of care than the 27. We rarely use 27s for anything. We use more and more 22s now than towards 27. So a little bit of product, and I'm a little resistant. So what I'm doing is I'm holding a pressure here, and I'm pushing through that. A little bit of product, readjust, product, readjust. And this is where people stop using the cannula because they get frustrated with it's blunt and it stops. But we just have to push through that resistance. There we go, to get where we want to be. And sometimes you can do this and push through, and there we go. And we did touch inside the mouth, but keep in mind we're not making the needle openings in the lip like we normally would, and so we're not worried about contaminating our opening because we only have one lateral opening that we're worried about. And here I want to get right there, fill some here. And now what I do, I'm going to assess the lip, and we'll finish up with the needle technique. So I looked at the symmetry. We did our cannula injections. There's one area here that we didn't pop the way I wanted to. So I'm going to do a little needle to touch up our filler, and it just allows us to get to a different plane. Now, she wanted kind of a flip in the front, and I like to come in to create that, to go to the GK point, start back here, come in at the wet dry, and I put a strut up right to that GK, and now I'm at that GK Glogo Klein point, and I put a little bolus right there. The columellar artery is there, so you're always watching, and I'm putting a strut in just to give that little flip up here. Now, to get this, the type of product you use is important. A product that has a bit of structure, and here's our GK point here, so we're gonna come in at the wet dry here. You can see I want just a little product here, and then an anti-grade injection up to the GK. I'm at the GK, and I'm gonna bolus a little there. And the product you use will determine how much flip you get versus one that draws water in more. So I wanna get a little more symmetry towards that, and I'm gonna inject here, and you can see that we're getting a nice front flip, which is what we wanted to, and now we're gonna do a little bottom flip, just anterior to the vermilion border across the bottom. This is one of the more sensitive ones, sorry about that. But it always looks great. It's worth the discomfort. And just two strips along the bottom, just like that.